Okay, so let's do a little exploring and think about the mechanics of this problem. First thing I'd like to know is, how do I go about requesting the data I want from this website? Again, I'm thinking about how I get to a point where I can actually do this programmatically. So most web browsers give you the ability to actually inspect individual elements of a web page. So in this case, let's just take a look at that selector. And if we do that, we can see all of the options right here in the HTML for the page. And based on our understanding of HTML, we know that it's these values here that we would need to submit as part of our post request. All right, the options for airports look very similar. So instead of looking at that, let's take a look at the data that's here. Now, a couple of things I want to point out here before we actually look at the HTML again. One is that for any given airport, this is reporting both domestic and international flights for that airport. Now, in my case, I'm not actually interested in that distinction. I simply want to know arrivals and departures. So where there's a value in both columns for a given month, I'm simply going to add them together. So this is one place where I'm doing a little bit of reshaping of the data. It's also the case that I've got these totals here in this column and then at the end of the rows for any given year. I'm simply going to ignore those. Again, a little bit of reshaping. Okay, so let's take a look at these elements. Now, as you might expect, these are laid out in a table. And if I scroll to the top, I can actually see that there's a class attribute for this particular table here. And this is going to help me when it comes time to actually parse this HTML in order to extract the data. So we've looked at both how to go about getting the values we're going to need to submit in a post request in order to get the data we need. And then we've looked at, once that data is presented to us, or in this case, to our program that's going to be accessing the site, how do we go about finding that data and pulling that data out of the HTML, or at least, where is it located in the HTML file?